The Longford School Board meeting, we go for a tooth to order, please.
Jim Nelson?
Yes.
Bob Coons?
He's excused.
Ellen Leach?
Here.
Andrea Anderson?
She's excused.
Erin Catherine?
Here.
Of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you all for being here on this slightly cooler Thursday. In the last couple of days, are there any opening comments by visitors from agenda items? Yes, Nancy Dionne?
Nancy Dionne, I noticed the enrollment, and a lot of times I don't hear a number for the enrollment. Could I get the enrollment for April, please?
The enrollment has actually been very stable since about the first of the year. The total enrollment for Rollinsford is 156. The total enrollment for Marshwood Middle and High Schools is 134. And the total enrollment at Summersworth High School is 21.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Any other comments or questions from comments? All right, seeing none, we will move right along. Approval of the consent calendar. We have our March 23rd minutes of the school board, the two March Rollinsford grade school newsletters that went out, and the enrollment for April.
I move to accept the consent calendar.
Second, any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye. All right. Announcements.
I have none this evening. I have a few things in the agenda, but no one else.
All right, I thought I would take this opportunity to bring board members up to speed on the superintendent search that's going on. I think some of you were at the last SAU board meeting. With the help of New Hampshire School Board Association, we went out and did, they went out and performed a full search for a superintendent. We had a number of candidates apply. We interviewed a smaller number of those candidates. We did first and second interviews. We culled it a little bit more. We did second interviews, and the search committee, which did a wonderful job. It was a large group, but everybody was able to find meeting times to get together. They did a good job. However, no candidate was found suitable to move forward. So we are taking the next steps. And again, on the advice of the New Hampshire School Board Association, we are now in the process of looking for an interim superintendent. And again, we have two interviews scheduled coming up for that. They are SAU board meetings, which are going to be posted. They are posted, but they'll immediately go into non-public. So, because those interviews will be held in non-public, so I'm hoping board members can make it to those interviews.
Yes.
I fully stand with that. And the search will be reopened. And the idea is that the search will be reopened in the fall rather than jump right into another search. Just like that. That's where we stand at the moment with that. Do we have any announcements? Discussion items. Principal update from Principal Lucas.
So in addition to the two newsletters that are in the packet, we also have one that was emailed to you on Monday for the beginning of April. And then I just wanted to highlight a couple of things. We had both RGS Reads last week, which was an evening for parents and students to come to school and explore literacy further, and then ways to support students at home through their literacy. And then on Tuesday night, we had our first ever family math night at the school. And both of them, we were really, really pleased with the way both of them turned out. Surprisingly, we had a good turnout for both of them. Last week was pouring rain, and we were like, oh, nobody's going to come out. We had a lot of kids. We had some of our older kids assisting and doing read-alouds in the library for the younger kids, and it was really quite nice. Shauna was over the moon, happy with the turnout, and felt really good about the success of the evening. And then on Tuesday night, our sixth graders once again helped to facilitate a number of the stations that were set up in the gym, and then played games, math games, with their families in their rooms that were particular to the type of math or the grade level math that they were in or are currently in. And we've had great feedback from parents. We had one sixth grade girl who returned today that her dad went home, and he's an engineer, raving about he wished he had had math the way we do here to explore and deconstruct and construct, and how he could see the students making deep meaning of the math concepts and not just sort of the algorithm. And he was like over the moon excited for his sixth grade daughter, who has been here with us the whole time. But he also has other children in the school too, so that was really nice. So it was great in terms of just getting family out and talking about learning and how to support kids at home. Additionally, the DOE came 2 weeks ago to do their site visit for our Title I program, and she raved about the school, sent multiple emails, left her card, asked if she could come back to visit just to spend the day at the school, not just to focus on literacy, which was really nice. Shauna has written a book for Stenhouse Publishing, and it comes out on May 16th. The title is Renew, so we're really excited for her, and she'll be speaking at a variety of different workshops about literacy and inquiry-based learning, so that's exciting. And then last spring, as you know, I applied for the Title I reallocation grant, and we were awarded that grant, upwards of like $25,000, which is a ton of money in the school district. And there's a team of 9 of us that are going to the Opal School Symposium in Portland, Oregon, the end of June, to spend 3 days with about 500 other educators that do inquiry-based learning in their schools. So we're really excited about that.
It's amazing.
I have information if you want to know about it.
Yeah.
So we're really excited.
Look forward to hearing more about that.
I don't know if we'll come back.
we'll find you.
End of June, I can still go.
It's true.
Yeah. Did we get that beaver implanted?
Chip her ear.
Thank you, Kate. It sounds like the 2 nights were very,
we were really, it was great.
That's really nice.
It's nice to see the kids super able to instruct their parents, which is really cool. Mm-hmm.
Were you here for it? Any comments you'd like to add to that?
That was great and beautiful. My kids had a blast. It's great to see, you know, what they're learning, how they're learning.
Yeah, we came to a math night and the games were fun. The kids were really excited about being here for it, which I thought was great. You know, I have a sixth grade son who was talking about math night all the week leading up to it, how excited he was for us to come. So something right happened.
It sounds wonderful.
It was a really good time.
Thank you. Noah doesn't seem to be here this evening, so we'll skip the Marshwood student update and go right to Bailey for the Somersworth student rep.
So our National Honor Society went to the Massachusetts State Summit yesterday. It was basically a conference in which we broke into several different workshops and kind of targeted reaching like globally and making an impact like beyond our community. It was one of my favorite conferences that I've been to throughout my high school career. It was a really great experience. And then we have our annual triviathon coming up the last day before April break, just like one last time to get the school together as a whole before vacation. Our student council had a spring conference in Exeter today that several of the underclassmen attended, just to kind of dip their toes in the water of conferences. And then we're also taking part in the wheelchair basketball little tournament on April 17th at Dover High School at 4:30 p.m. And all of the proceeds from that tournament will benefit the Unified Sports Day to be held in May. As far as class councils go, our freshmen are selling drinks after school as a fundraiser, and it's like surprisingly very successful. They're just planning more fundraisers. The sophomores are exploring prom venues, and they also have a games night at the school on April 21st, I believe, from 7 to 9. The junior class is just planning prom, so prom is May 6th. We are selling tickets and we're just purchasing favors and everything like that. Very exciting times. And the senior class is just planning Project Grad, and then senior banquet, they have their graduation date, so now they can kind of go forth on like planning events and everything like that. Our Interact Club, which is essentially just a community service club, is helping with the Somersworth Rec Department Easter egg hunt on tomorrow. At 4:30, we'll just be interacting with the children. And we also have a car wash on May 13th from 10 to 2 at VIP Auto. So sports, for sports, softball and baseball are in full swing. And then track had our first meet on this past Tuesday at Exeter High School. And actually our javelin people did really, really well. We like took the first place overall, which is really awesome.
First name, second.
Yeah.
They really like to call them athletes.
Yes, athletes. So we took the SATs on April 5th, so those are all done out of the way. Personally say that's a huge weight off the shoulders of many, so we also started our new classes yesterday. We're in quarter four now, and then we have a college fair on April 19th from 5:30 to 7. I think it's something like over 60 colleges that are being represented, which is just really awesome to have that opportunity right in our gym. So,
yeah, it's great. So when is graduation date?
June 7th at 7, I think, at the
window.
Not 7.
Six.
I wasn't asking the time.
Okay, it's June 7th.
I'm just curious about the date.
That I didn't
know. I wondered if it was going to be before school is out. It is.
Oh.
Yeah. Lucky seniors, huh?
Yeah.
Thank you, Lily. You're welcome to stay, as always. You're also free to leave if anytime you want to. Thank you. Yeah, okay. The next discussion item is the special ed spreadsheet, which
we have a slight change.
Yep, I see there was a slight change. Do you want to just explain the change?
Sure. We have two students that were no longer in need of services. So that's the shift there.
Yep. Any questions?
Still students attending, but just not in need of services.
I think that's always a good thing.
Yes.
So does that mean that they're...
Yes,
I do know.
Yes, you're
Does that mean that their base tuition moves from the special ed line to the... It does.
Okay. That's a very good question. Yes.
Yeah. So we've made the adjustments.
Thank you. The next discussion item was added last meeting when Tom mentioned that he'd like to see more select board school board partnership. We can, one of the things that we will be talking about a little bit later on, communication is always open between the select board and the school board and the school district and the town district. And one of the things that we're going to be discussing in a little bit and taking action on is the town, as many, all of us town residents know, are going to be working on a number of culverts. One of them happens to be right down here on Willie Street, and they need permission from the school district to cross the school property. And it's all very interesting because, you know, it's all town property. It's the same voters, the same town owns all the property, but they need special permission. So the select board reached out to Jenny, and I think in some cases we're ready to get something. And also there's a lot of work that goes on between the two that we may not always be aware of. With the loan applications that have been made and the bonding things that have been made, Marie has been a big help in having to provide financial information, because all the financial information of the town is important as they consider loans, and so that includes all the school financial information. So there's a lot that goes on, and if any of you have any specifics you'd like to talk about, any partnerships you'd like to talk about, we can, and we can leave it on there for further.
Yeah, I think reading it from the comments here is his main.
The next discussion item is the board retreat, and I forgot to mention in my sort of reminder email that we really need to plan this. We really need to come up with a date for this.
Which has been so easy to do.
It's been so easy to do. We really think it's important that all of us are there, and so if we come up with one, it might be a little different. If all of us agree on one, it might not work out well, but we can run it by the other. We can come up with a couple of dates. I believe, Emily, it was your suggestion last time that maybe we try not for a week, a day?
Yeah, a weekend, right?
You had mentioned that, I'm just re-mentioning that because. But the rest of April is probably out based on vacation schedules. Jenny's on vacation the last week. And the rest of the things are on vacation.
And Sunday's Easter still, yeah.
Oh, yeah, quite. We wouldn't do it this Sunday's the same government, so it is.
So we're at May.
I could do May 7th.
I could do the afternoon. Or from you.
So you want to shoot for?
So what if we wanted to, like about at maximum 3 hours? Max, that would be a max.
2 to 5?
2 to 5.
Yeah. I'm actually leaving this all up to you. I grew up in a family where Sundays we were not allowed to make outside commitments. And I still have a hard time making commitments for Sunday because as children we were not allowed to make outside. All right. At the SAU office at the moment.
Yes.
So at the moment, so we'll leave that as the tentative.
Yes.
For tentative, we'll get it out to everyone and.
And then we'll.
See where that goes. All right. All right, thank you. Time, enough time.
It's open students weekend, just in case that changes anything for you.
That's duck race, right?
Duck race!
Why is that not on my?
Saturday.
Oh, Saturday, that's Saturday.
But I'm just letting you know that it's the same weekend.
I was gonna say, why isn't that on my calendar? Well, it is, it's week for Saturday.
Yes, I'm just letting you know, but I don't know if you have obligations for this.
I only have obligations for the duck race that is misspelled on my calendar, I see. Let that go. But but you're okay with the library stuff?
Yeah, Sunday.
All right. Well, okay, that crisis averted.
Yeah, all good.
Okay. And we'll get that, I'll get an email out to the other members of the board and get that straightened out. All right, I did not print this out, but the next discussion item is the 2017-18 meal price.
Increase?
Increase, and one of the reasons we increase every year is that at the moment for our free and reduced lunch, the federal government pays a certain amount of money. Our meal price does not reach that amount. The federal government feels that they should not be subsidizing us for more than we actually have our folks pay. So I believe that's sort of in a nutshell.
Correct.
And so I didn't print it out. So every year, I believe we raise it.
10 cents.
10 cents. So if you want to see what you have there.
So begrudgingly, I ask you to consider this because we have to get closer to their mark, of course, which they raise each year as well.
I was just going to say, does they just keep moving it? But again, my understanding, we're showing good faith by raising it every year, and therefore they don't yell at us.
Correct.
They don't yell at us.
Well, then they don't.
They don't come
take away our federal funding, so. Right now, anyway.
So we're going up 10 cents, is my understanding, from.
You need a motion to accept? Move to accept the meal plan price increase.
I will second that. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
I am voting as well these right now because to make sure that we have at least 3 people voting. I mean, you two form, but anyway, never mind. All right, the next discussion item is the building fund use. You all may remember that last meeting, I very likely made this wonderful blanket statement that we can use it like a sort of like a capital improvement plan, but then we decided maybe we better find out exactly what we can do. Have you been able to, either of you look through this?
I did read it, what I could. It's kind of blurry.
Well, here's the the key points, which were sort of pointed out here, but the key point is that this is not a contingency fund. It is indeed a fund that we can put money into and then take money out, much like the CIP fund that the town has. We would, so by warrant, we can put money into it, which we have been doing, and then by warrant, we take money out of it. So, for instance, there are a number of things on the list of big items to be done in the school. Some of it is replacing windows in the annex. Some of it is ventilation for the whole building. Dick and Kate did a nice job doing out a 5 or 6 year plan. I have a copy of it here somewhere. There are roofing that's going to need to be done. And so we can actually put in money and be saving money towards some of these big ticket items and then ask to have it be removed from that fund to pay for some of those items.
So, for example, like the lifts, that we just, if we were to write a similar warrant article, it would, instead of saying raise and appropriate, it would say remove from capital improvement fund X dollar or...
Yes, I mean, the town does it. We've never done one in my time, so, but yes, it would be like
point
that.
Being
I was going to say we did the fire alarm.
Asbestos.
And the asbestos.
Yeah. That's been before my time.
It's my first couple of years.
Okay. It was before my time. Yeah, so I mean, it's. I think it's too bad that we didn't know this earlier because we might have raised the amounts that we were putting into it as we started seeing them. But better late than never, it's a good time to start. And we'll talk more about it as we get into the next budget season. I think we're ready to sort of cap the special ed fund and now pay more attention to this fund.
Could we put, we've already said we'll only put 25 in.
This year, the warrant that passed was 25. And that,
but we can't put extras from.
That's a very good question.
We can say we did, if we have $20,000 left, and can we say we want to put it in this capital improvement fund?
No, I believe it has to be a warrant. It has to be anything that you're going to do with those dollars. Like, we could say, you could say right now we have a surplus, as you know, we have a memo to you folks to take care of some projects based on what's sitting in the bottom line. But we can't put it in that fund without it's being a warrant for the voters to know that that's what you're looking to do with dollars.
Yeah.
So going forward, I think, as Judy had stated, probably next year as you get ready to write warrants, probably leave spend where it is, and then what you would probably do is just increase, you know, maybe you asked for 50,000 or 60 or half of what's left, or because there's a variety of ways you can do it. I believe one year we did it half of what was left for surplus, and then sometimes we do a specific amount.
And that will be, it'll be interesting, because, and the other thing that you've heard me say, because I'm a rep to the budget committee, I also hope to be a part of the CIP, and then so that the town can see along with what they're putting into the CIP, what the school is seeing for big ticket items, and then how we're going to start saving money for.
I'll just clarify that Jenny is correct. One year we attempted to put 50% or whatever, and the Department of Revenue indicated we had to actually designate an amount. We couldn't put a percentage of, we had to designate a specific amount, just for future reference.
Yeah. And we can always make it be, you know, we can say $200,000, and we can say,
you know,
say up to that amount. Up to, and then so any further questions, discussion on that? Is there anything else we need to do? We have that clarified now. And excellent work finding this, because this went back to 2002.
Oh, yeah, 2002.
Yeah. So thank you for finding that for us. Excellent. don't see any action items on our listed out.
Well, we'll do it under new business.
Okay.
That's okay.
All right. Financial update, that we have the budget.
And then you have our memo, and we'd like to update the memo that we sent. The memo you received from Caitlin regarding some potential projects.
Mm-hmm.
So the technology part of that is accurate and we're fine. We thought if we had some dollars, there are some things that we do need technology-wise.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, and then the building part, we have a few updates. So the complete paving will actually be $28,000.
Okay.
The food warmer is actually about $3,400. And the annex windows also have a little abatement issue. So I believe it's the caulking, correct? That has asbestos in it. And so not something we would know unless somebody came in to think about how to remove the windows, that was discovered. So in order to abate that, it would run us about $20,000. So the new building side of dollars that we're looking at is about $117,000. So the total on this new sheet will now be $133,500.
Nothing can be cheap, can it?
Nothing can be cheap.
And you know, wasn't there someone out there that said, can you guarantee there's no more asbestos? And the answer was always, as we know.
Well, and that's, you know, and I
didn't think with us.
You gotta love it.
It must have worked on everything. Yeah.
It's good for everything.
Julie, you have to love the 1966.
So.
Okay. All right, so that's, and we don't have to act on anything tonight on this, right? This is April. It's made too late. It's better to act on
it would be
as soon as possible.
Well, I'll tell you why, because Dick's going to have some work to do to line up vendors and make all of this happen, not to mention what we already have going with the warrants that were approved. So
okay.
It would be helpful. We believe we have accounted for every possible situation, and as you can see right now, the bottom line is at about $284,000.
Yes. Now, one of the reasons we have the surplus is that some special ed dollars have been released.
Correct.
Have been unencumbered. People have been off it in Marshwood, that's one thing, and then some other amount of money has been released. So we have a pretty good surplus, and that's
why we're coming.
That's less than half the surplus at the moment, which puts us in pretty good shape. But discussion, thoughts. Don't spend it down, it will be returned to the town, which the town will use to offset the tax increases. This is work that needs to be done. Some of this work we put off, Aaron, before you joined the board. We said that we would take the shed. We were hoping to have enough surplus for the shed, for instance.
Yeah, that would be an encumbered shed with the other bins.
Now, I don't know, and again, I will ask for
you
can jump in on this too, but if people are feeling uncomfortable, we might say, let's, we can go ahead and approve the building side of it, and then hold off on the
Is that everyone's update?
currently everybody has one. They're just, as you know, exceeded their life expectancy by quite a bit, and they're always breaking down, so it's 1,000 here, it's 1,200 here, and we're just trying to, as we said we've been doing since I came, is that we want to keep up with the technology. If we're going to bring it in, it needs to be working, and so we're moving to replace them.
And this is part of the technology plan that we, it's part of our fiber technology.
Yeah, we actually have one in the budget for next year. I mean, we're trying to keep up with it, but this is just a great way to really get up with it, and we have some that are, two that are down right now, so.
I believe all of this technology is part of our fiber plan, right? We feel that we have some money this year that would be good to put towards this.
What it does is it allows us to keep chipping away at things. I would say if we had to look at the building priority to immediately sort of help us with some planning, the shed probably would, the shed or the Zendesk? I know, it's all a priority.
I guess in my mind I'm thinking about that, so we had put money in the budget to pass for the windows and the annex on one side. So we're going to be doing that. It doesn't make sense not to do the, you're not going to pay for two separate abatements. I mean, that's because it's so expensive to get them to come in and then clean up and then come back to do the other side. Does that, you're not going to do
no,
that?
No, I understand. I understand what you're saying.
So that's sort of then, which wouldn't have been the priority, but now kind of rises to a priority because you're not going to bring them in and set them up at separate times. You're just going to get it done.
I feel that in a way we have some found money this year with the money that's been released that was slated to go to special ed, that money that's been released is really found money. It's money that we were not expecting to have in the budget. And that prior boards have been very clear about saying when we have found money, we will put it into the building. We will do our best to keep up with the building so that we don't have to do warrant articles to
ask for it later.
So that's where I stand on it. I think because it's sort of half of what we have available at the moment, we've been here rapidly winding down and hoping for if it still leaves us a pretty good cushion going forward. So that's my take on it. So at any time you feel comfortable, we can make a motion or we can continue the discussion, really. I don't want to rush anybody into this.
I guess I'm moved to complete the list. All the improvements in technology acquisitions, I guess.
And the total again was?
133.5, so maybe not to exceed 134. That would be helpful to make sure I at least capture everything.
Second motion.
Okay.
All right, so we have a motion to spend some of our money that appears that we will have to spend on the technology and the building not to exceed 134. Any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you. We'll get started.
So let's see, was this on, where are we? Are we on budget here still? Are we still on budget? Are there any other budget things that we should? Okay, any other questions on the budget? All right, we'll move on. New business. There's nothing really listed. But
no, so so in order to assist the town, I have in front of you a couple pieces of paper. So one is the wetlands letter of agreement that would authorize me to sign and allow folks access to property as needed. And then the other is a licensed agreement that the attorney drew up that would allow us to allow folks the opportunity to come on the property as needed to do the culvert work, and doesn't obligate us to sign any sort of easement. It is just a license agreement. The attorney wrote it up. She had the information from Hoyle and Tanner as far as what they were doing, and what I need from you folks is your authority, because I'm attending the meeting tomorrow at 11 a.m. for the great signing, so.
Are they gonna be on the playground while the kids are here?
Well, no, I hope they'll work around what is.
These are good questions to be asking, but from what I understand, Hoyle and Tanner, most of the work and they'll be working and movement will be within the town's right, the right of way the town already owns, already has, of course. But they will. The reason this needs to be signed now is that work needs to start like in June, maybe for this. And my understanding is that no. They should not be traipsing across playgrounds or anything like that. That's my understanding. It's a very good question.
Yeah, I'm gonna feel like you have much choice in the matter, really. I mean, it does concern me, like, we don't know who these people, you know, like, the people who will be that are working on them, we're giving them access to school property. Do we have any assurances?
So Hoyle and Tanner, the engineer, I'm sure, will be working closely with whomever. Mm-hmm. And then typically what happens is they will come to the school, introduce who may be coming back and forth or who may be on the property and have some conversations with us. I don't know the life of the property. I mean, I'm aware we have to think about possibly some busing issues, but as it gets closer and as they start, those are the details that my conversation with the select folks have been so far. So we will certainly make sure they will introduce themselves. I think about some of the building projects we've done in Summersworth, and we know we have a construction management group. They have subcontractors. Their job is to make sure folks are identified and all of those things happen, and we're just not having strangers wander around. So that would be a piece that, I'm sure as it gets closer, they will come to us and say, hey, let me just tell you, these are going to be some of the folks. Certainly Dick and Kate will know, and I'm sure they'll have conversations with Dick, most importantly.
So our job is to, we're not going to sign it. We're going to give permission to Superintendent Mosca to be at the great signing, because it is not just the school. It's for other properties around town as well. So.
All right. Yeah, I guess I'll make a motion to give Jenny permission to and sign on our behalf, the great signing.
No. And we have a second. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Thank you so much.
We may see this come back to us in the form of a warrant or something, where we grant a permanent easement, but right now this is all being done this way with a license and a temporary easement. It may come back to us next year if the town, if the town's engineers would feel that they would prefer to have a permanent easement. But anyway, we're there. We're moving forward. The town's going to be able to.
Sign the permanent easement is we have to present it to the voters. So in essence, there would be a warrant so that they're aware, and they would give the authority, because
You don't have the authority as the board. I, as the superintendent, don't have the authority, because it's not ours. But the license at least allows the temporary access until we see. She also, the attorney thought that this would be fine and meet the needs. But as work needs to be done years down the road, they want to have the ability to come and, you know, obviously continue to do work if needed, so.
It's all very interesting, because the voters, all of us who vote in town, live in town, vote in town, are both the townspeople and the school district. I mean, so it's like, we give permission for ourselves to cross our land. It's very interesting, but.
Thank you.
Legalities. Is there any other new business to come before the board? Old business, connections.
Surveys went out. Our chance went out last week, and March was out the week before. Truthfully, I have not checked to see how many have been filled out yet, so it'll be.
I'll send a reminder.
Yeah.
I forgot.
You mean to fill yours out?
Yeah.
I see, okay.
It's not good.
Yeah. Yes, I agree with that. Reminder would be a good thing to do. But yeah, so that's all.
So do you think you will send a reminder? To both Walter Grace and.
Do you want to check that one first and see what you, I mean.
We have gotten a ton of responses.
Probably not.
Yeah, if you need to send something, let me know.
I'll take a look, if I feel like.
If you feel it's warranted. If you feel it's warranted.
I don't want to like post it, the links on Facebook or anything, because then any.
Oh, right.
Any Joe Schmo can go throw it out.
No, that's true, we don't.
So we don't.
It is supposed to be for the students.
Students, yes.
That is correct. Although I believe I might have some that have no answers. Because I go through it when you say, check out this link, I don't think I didn't make any answers. Oh, okay, well, good, but you reset it then. All right, good, thank you for doing that. We'll see, it'll be interesting to see how it compares to even response to last year and things like that, see how it's going.
Very, very.
Anything on transportation? Does anyone have any idea if any of our students are riding on the Marshwood bus?
Comes over the line. Bits of feedback, third-party feedback that I've gotten are, the bus is so crowded that the kids don't want to take it. And one person said that you have to sign up for it, it's so crowded. So, but I haven't heard that otherwise. So I don't know. And again, I haven't tried it. So
I can check with Mary.
But I do know that it has stopped at the Legion. I have a.
You've seen.
Eagle eye out there.
Perfect.
Scouted for me and has said that it.
So it's come over.
She knows it has actually gone to the Legion at one time at least.
Okay.
So I assume that means there was no one for it all.
Do you want me to just check with them?
Is there any follow-up you want to do with that?
It would be interesting to know. I just don't know. I mean, I guess the drivers would know just anecdotally whether people are using it, right?
Yep. Why don't I check?
Because I assume we're paying whether we have riders or not.
That would be a good question. So
that's a good question.
Okay. Let me ask.
All right, let's find all that out.
Yeah.
They don't make the trip over.
Don't we avoid?
So I would think we would only be charged if they.
Okay.
But I don't, I'm not sure, so. All right.
It is hard to know.
We may be paying because they've got something too.
Yeah.
Right, which
yeah.
Which I thought might be the case, but we'll find out. And I know we had asked you to look into also getting the honor rolls from Marshall. And I don't know when they come out even, so I'm just.
I thought she was going to bring that information when we did the joint meeting.
Oh, is she? Okay.
That was one of the, so we may want to put that back on the list, but that was one of the conversations.
No, I wasn't sure, okay.
Yeah.
All right. All right, so thank you. So you're going to follow up on, you're just going to follow up on whether it's come over.
Yeah, I'm going to find out if it's come over, how the charge is being worked out. And our sort of rival support.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I can.
Thank you. Marshwood contract items, Jenny has a running list, which we'll be getting much more into that in the fall-ish timeframe, I think, when we start. We are currently in the second year. We are actually in the second year of a six-year contract, but at the end of 6 years, which means so sort of the beginning of the fourth year, we will talk about renewing it for another 4 years. So I don't want us to lose sight of the fact that we have to start thinking about renewing it in college time. So that's why that's on there.
This may be a better question for the joint meeting, but with the cuts to their state funding, being that we pay a percentage, I wasn't on board when we negotiated the contract, so I don't know the details of it. Do we have protections in place, or can our price per pupil jump?
Oh, we have no protections in place in terms of our price per pupil jumping, as long as the price follows the formula that's right in the contract. Now, I believe that's a great question for the joint meeting. How does the way they are going to now start paying, cuts they're going to make, and how they're going to start paying, and how does that affect our tuition? I think that's a great question to ask. One of the protections we do have in place is if at any time they are not delivering the education we believe we have contracted for, we can opt out at any time. That was essentially the only protection that was really put in that way.
I can go in there.
And we're not going there at the moment. Not at the moment.
That's what I mean.
But if there's actually this might be a good time to talk about the joint meeting. So the article in the paper, I know I sent you guys, were you able to unzip it? I may not even have looked at it yet. As well as some of their budget, as well as a couple of their frequently asked questions. And if you look toward the end of the frequently asked questions, it's awfully long, but if you look at the end, you see both the state formula for how much they pay for student and of course, and the Rollinsford tuition formula is there. So that's very interesting. And also it was interesting the way they do their budgets. They do a lot of summarizing. And they do regular education.
I can't pull it up.
They do special education. Anyway, it's very interesting. So I'm thinking that our joint meeting can be a really nuts and bolts sort of budgetary meeting. What does this mean for us? There's talk about pushing costs of athletics onto the booster clubs, which means parents and whoever else will have to do a lot of the work and to raise the money for students to.
I think it was mostly for freshmen athletics, is that right?
Well, I think they haven't been finally, I'm not sure there've been final decisions made.
Okay.
Right. I mean, my guess is that we have a number of questions on this moment. The fact that class sizes are going to get bigger, those kinds of things.
And they're still in the throes of their budget cycle. So I think it's...
Which must be so hard right now with that. That's a crazy...
Yeah, to make some decisions.
...change so. To have to navigate. I do not envy that position at all.
No. Not at all.
Mm-hmm.
their budget isn't finalized till end of May, June.
When it goes to the voters, I think, by June.
I mean, so I don't know about how you all feel, but from this article, I had probably about 10, at least 10 questions jump out of the article. And I was thinking that what we could do as a board, and I will write this to the others as well, is that since we have an SAU board meeting on the 20th, we could be thinking of some questions.
Yeah.
And then on the 20th, we could just sort of share our questions with each other. We don't even have to do it formally. We don't have to have a meeting or anything to do it. We can share them around and sort of say, yeah, let's.
I'm okay with that.
You won't? That's right, you're gonna be in Washington, DC. Well, if you think of any questions, please share them. And because I don't think the week of the 20th is too late to let them know what we think the agenda's gonna be. I know that's only next week, isn't it?
Next Thursday.
It's next Thursday, next Friday.
They're on.
Or maybe that's too late.
They'll be on vacation.
Oh, yeah.
So then it might not be bad, because then we'll get some response the following week.
Yeah, but I think if we can, if we as a board can, in the next week or so, say we want this to be a real nuts and bolts sort of budgetary meeting with other questions, we'll open it up to whoever our public is there and all that stuff, that, you know, we're going to come prepared with questions and give them an idea of what the questions are, so they can be prepared.
Absolutely.
So I think we have something by the end of April, the time that gives them. That gives them almost 2 weeks to get ready for it, so we'll sort of look to do that. And we can do that by email, because it's planning to, it's sort of a draft document, so we can do that by email.
Okay.
Is that all right with folks? Does it sound like?
Sure.
Yeah, the right way to go? Okay. Andrea did say, when she said she would not be able to make this meeting because she's on a business trip, that there has not been any further meetings with the, on the late start. She reported to us the last time. Any other old business on anybody's mind that we don't have listed here? Okay, future meetings. April 20th is the SAU board meeting where we will be interviewing an interim superintendent candidate.
Is that at 6:30?
6:30, correct. At the SAU office. For those of you that are interested, Emily, the first budget committee meeting is December
26th.
What month
was that, December
26th? Yeah, I'm sorry, I'll be there. There's also a May 8th SAU board meeting, which is also at 6:30, and I believe we will also be interviewing another interim superintendent candidate that day.
Maybe
at least, or one or more. May 8th. It's a Monday.
Yeah, that'll be a little bit of business that
right.
I have.
We do have a real SAU budget meeting,
yeah.
And then there will be, and then. We're also carving out time to do some interim superintendent interviews then as well.
Are you
interviewing
again?
No.
I thought
I'd
reapply.
Is that
also
the date of the
thing in Concord?
No,
it's
no.
On a Wednesday.
It is May. It might be that week.
Yeah.
It's May 3rd, Aaron.
Thank you. Also, it's the week before.
It's the week before. I'm going to present it here.
Oh, I actually
Dawn and
I. Should we have a
meeting? Well, no, people didn't know. Jenny will be there.
I will be there.
No, Aaron. Jenny will be there.
Yeah.
Awesome. And then our next school board meeting is May 11th, and then the MSAD. Budget meetings there, so. Any other meetings that we've missed to put on here?
And right now, you're going to let May 7th, you're going to let folks Our other two folks know?
Yes.
I hope that helps. You too.
All right. Vacation week next week?
Yes.
Woo! Well, so no school events for this year, but next week, that's fine.
The only thing that's really coming up is the PTO's ice cream social, What's the Scoop, is Sunday, April 30th from 1 to 4 at Legion. No, you won't be. But I signed you up for Hilltop with the Kids.
Okay. Yeah, I will have to get one of them.
Well, we'll save your bowl of ice cream.
Yeah.
One bowl of ice cream, yes.
1 to 4. It went home and whistles back today. It was on the last newsletter that was out on Monday.
I should probably be pulling that out.
Well, good luck.
June 20th.
Yeah, good luck getting those kids backpacks.
Ice cream is not generally something that he will let pass by, however. I think so, yeah.
That should actually be a fun event. All right, we do have non-public this evening, but we will take closing comments from visitors. Nancy?
Yes, I was at a select board's meeting and Jeff came in and mentioned something about fencing.
It's misunderstanding, so no problem.
Okay. Okay, then my other question is I believe when you first started out budgeting for the shed that it was $30,000 and not $40,000. Is there a reason for, has cost gone up that much?
It's the prep work that needs to be done. Well, it's $40,000. There's the prep work that had,
I think that the original price was the shed itself.
Okay.
Shed that had the wall and the construction. And that was an estimate at that time, too.
Anything else? Any other comments by visitors? Comments by the board? All right, then thank you all for being here. It's appreciated. Stay warm out there. Thanks for the week.
We'll have a roll call.
Great, have a great night.